55 minutes. When Holy Prophet migrated to Medina, it's a very interesting thing. He started his medinal life from writing a document which is known to be the first written constitution of Medina, Al-Wathiqa or As-Sahifa. There are two views on it. The historians have two views. Some of the Islam Muslim historians say that this total Sahifa, consisting of 63 articles, which finally became the constitution of the city-state of Medina. Some say that this was written in two parts. Some articles related to the Muslims, the immigrants and the settled Muhajirin and Ansars were written in the separate, and the part of this Sahifa document related to the Jews and their allies was written separately. One view. And one view is that it was written as a whole sum just once. It was not written in two separate times. So we take both of these views into consideration. As far as the whole Sahifa, the document, the constitutions were written in one stance, it makes the matter whole clear. But if we take this view that it was written in two different dates, then keep in view that first part of Wasiqa, which was written first, that was related to the Jews. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, created a society, integral society. And he created an alliance between Muslims and Jews, tribes and their allies. And putting all these Muslims and non-Muslims together, he announced that all these Muslims and non-Muslim tribes and their allies, from today, they form together an ummah. This is a very important word. Holy Prophet declared, together the Muslims and Jews and their allies, all them together to form a single community. And he used the word ummah, al-wahida. And after al-Badr, Ghazwatul Badr, at second stance, Holy Prophet wrote another part of the document between Muhajirin and Ansar to create the same kind of relations between the Muslim groups. But he preferred to create this relationship with the non-Muslim Jews first. And then he turned toward the Muslims. And the word which I would like to quote here, the word very significant aspect, which Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said. These were very important words. Holy Prophet said, this is the document and this is the constitution which he wrote between the Mu'mineen and Muslimin of Quraysh and Yasrib. And those who will be their clients and their allies, and those who will fight with them the war of defense of the city of Medina, and those who will remain with them together, Holy Prophet said, innahum ummatun wahidatun min dunin nas. From today, they are becoming one ummah with the exception of all other people. Holy Prophet says, this is a compact, a document from Muhammad, the Prophet, between the Mu'mineen and Muslimin of Quraysh and Yasrib, and those who join them, who become their allies, attach themselves in this document and fight the war of defense together with them for the defense of city of Medina. He said, innahum ummatun wahidatun min dunin nas. From today, they form one people, one single community, one single nation, to the exclusion of others. Here in this is the first and second article of the Sahifa of Medina. Here the Jews and non-Muslims have been mentioned just as allies. But coming to the Article 28 of the same constitution of Medina. Here Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, says, Inna Yahuda Bani Auf Ummatun Ma'al Mu'mineen. The Jews of Bani Auf, Holy Prophet said, they and all their allies from today, they are the ummah along with the Muslims. They become the part of the single ummah along with the Muslims. And he said, that inna ummatun wahidatun. And then Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, states, walil yahud dinahum, walil muslimina dinahum. إن يهود بني أوف أمة مع المؤمنين لليهود دينهم وللمسلمين دينهم ومواليهم وأنفسهم. ابن هشام, ابن إسحاق, ابن زنجوي, ابن كثير, all these Islamic historians has reported Article 628 of the Constitution of Medina. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, says the Jews of Bani Auf and all of their allies, and their allies were, he said, the Jews of Banu Najjar, the Jews of the tribe of Banu Haris, the Jews of tribe of Banu Jusham, the Jews of tribe of Banu Sa'ida, the Jews of tribe of Banu Aus, the Jews of tribe of Banu Saliba, and the tribe of the Jews of tribe of Banu Shutaiba. He says all these Jews tribes who have become part and parcel of the document, part and parcel of this constitution, who has accepted this constitution of the city state of Medina, he said all these Jews of Banu Auf and their allies form a part of single ummah. They have become a single community with the mu'mineen, with the Muslims. This is a very important, significant aspect which needs a thorough study. Holy Prophet is not saying that they today are becoming closer friends. They are allies of one another. They will live together. Holy Prophet has mentioned here clearly two things. Number one, Yahud, the Jews, would be free in practicing their religion, and Muslim would be free in practicing their religion. This is one clause. And second clause, the first clause of the article is that from today, Muslims and Jews will live together as a single ummah, as a single community, as a single jama'ah. So they will fight for each other. They will save, protect the rights of each other. They will provide every kind of facility to each other. They will trust on each other. And they will live as a single ummah and jama'ah in the city state of Medina. This is the basis how Islam endorses and propagates the concept of peace and peaceful coexistence, that he, first time in the history, he gave the idea of nationality, a political unity, a political community, and gave that political community the title of Ummah. Today, we are only aware of the Ummah al-Muslimah, the concept of Ummah Muslimah, Muslim community. We are aware of the concept of Muslim Ummah. This is one aspect based on religion. But Holy Prophet has introduced another aspect of Ummah too, that is based on political unity, social unity, economic unity, mutual working, living in a peaceful coexistence. So this relationship has also converted them instead of being a different entities living together, Holy Prophet has converted them together into one Ummah. So he became the founder of the concept of integration. Now we are talking of integration today. We are talking of today multiculturalism. We are talking of integration. And today we are talking of respect and freedom and liberty of the religion. Everybody, religious freedom and cultural freedom. Holy Prophet said that Jews and Muslims and every tribe would be freely allowed to practice its own culture. They would be allowed to practice own religion. They would be free to practice their own customary laws. They would be free to practice their own tribal traditions and conventions. Nobody would be forced in matter of faith. No single tribe or party would be forced in matter of culture, in matter of their tradition. The tradition of blood money was kept. The customary laws of the tribes were kept as such. Nothing was disturbed. And their religion, they were on their freedom. But in spite of all this fact, Holy Prophet said, you have to practice freely your own religion, but you have to live as a single community and ummah. This is the concept what the today's humanity is looking for. And we are looking for peace. And we are searching for peace today. And we want this kind of beautiful society integrated with multi-faith people, multi-ethnicity people, multicultural people. And we want to look for a society which where the people of belonging to different faiths, people belonging to different cultures, people belonging to different ethnic backgrounds, people speaking different languages, people having different traditions, people having different conventions, keeping all these identities intact, but Is there any possibility that they may live as a community, single community? So this concept was laid down for the first time in the history of mankind by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. I am shocked when I listen from some so-called Muslims that we and non-Muslim cannot be a single community. We cannot get integrated in one society. We have dissimilarities. This and this and this, and we have many dissimilarities in religion, in culture, in faith, in language. And we are today under the banner, wrongly under the banner of Islam, we are preferring the isolation model. And we are rejecting the concept of integration. We have to rethink that this is not Islam. This is not teaching of the Prophet of Islam. Look at the seerah and the conduct of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. When he established a multi-ethnic, multicultural, multi-faith society of Medina, and he declared the whole society, giving them religious freedom, cultural freedom, ethnic freedom, but declared the whole society will be known as Ummatun Wahida. Just one Ummah. It means if we are true followers of Prophet Muhammad and true followers of Islam, so we have to adopt the method of integration today. And we have to establish an atmosphere of peaceful coexistence as Holy Prophet introduced in his life for all religions. And this constitution, which is known as As-Sahifa, the title word given by all authorities was Kitabul Muada'ah. You can go through any historic authority. It's written, this was Muada'ah. And go, you can read any translator of the Western world or the Islamic history. Al-Muada'ah had several meanings, seven meanings, Al-Muwada. This document, historical and constitutional document, was given the title Kitabul Muwada'ah. And the Muwada'ah means treaty of peace. Muwada'ah means treaty of non-aggression. Al-Muwada'ah means treaty of peaceful coexistence. It means treaty of friendship. It means treaty of renunciation of violence. It means treaty of non-belligerency. It means treaty of reciprocal guarantee of security. Because of shortage of time, there are authorities. Instead of going into the references authorities, I have given you a summary of all meanings which have been adopted by the Westerners, by Orientalists, and by Muslim scholars, historians together. There is no eighth meaning of this term. So every single meaning, whichever authority has adopted or chosen, it means peace and security and friendship and non-violence. So Holy Prophet started his Medinan life from the pact of non-violence. He started his Medinan life